Season 5, Episode 2, Ghost Town.
Hello, I'm Roostepher Batsinger, the rightful caretaker of Curdle Holler. But did you know I'm also the grand poobah of Company Holler, a brand new business affair? Land, we have been busy these past few weeks, setting up a refinery and scaring up houses for the myriad monsters who have already joined the mining concern.
That means Company Holler, idiot.
Percy, go on now. If you are watching this movie reel, I offer you the chance to get in on the ground floor of something incredible. Come work for me in the mines of Company Holler. Break those rocks and carry the fried crystals to my refinery, and I will transform your afterlife. Indeed, I will take care of your every need.
Hey, that ain't fair. What are they getting?
To start, I will give you a free home, which includes both bed and water closet, plus 3 squares a day, access to a church, saloon, and similar edifices. And if you work hard and meet your quota, we'll give you credit to spend at the company's store.
No thanks.
Well, Percy, what if I said the company store is the only retailer authorized to sell the exclusive, adorable country rock critters? Collect country rock stones and break them apart to reveal one of 66 unique, charming goblin prospectors who will dig a tunnel right to your heart.
I already got this one, Daddy.
Sounds like you need to earn more credits down in the mine.
What? I ain't never gonna work in no mine.
Now, I'm aware of the rumors, but there's no evidence of Company Holler employees being stretched, squashed, or cut by willy-nilly blades, or exploded by a toxic gas. But don't take my word for it. Here's some fulsome laudations from my own employees.
My brother and me been in the mine for a couple of weeks now, cause we're saving up for more of those enchanted country rock critters. Especially the hard hat one, or the dynamite dude.
We'll trade you for the one on the cigarette break.
I can't wait to leave my perfectly good life for one down in the mine. See you there.
Y'all in Curdle Holler.
Well, I think I speak for everyone when I say gross.
I find myself rather spooked by this rapid expansion of Roostepher Batsinger's Company Holler Town. His illegitimate seizure of the caretaker title seems not to unnerve the town's monsters at all.
Indeed, some of our citizens seem to be enthusiastically marching to their dooms
and surrendering their frightful countenances in exchange for useless company town currency.
Plus collectible figurines.
Oh yeah, talk about them little, what you call them?
Country rock critters.
Yeah, they ain't that cute. Ain't worth working a full day in the mine. Mining's hard on your bones. I tell you about mining now. You go down in one of them in a little cart and just get out of a little skip hoist.
Sheriff, love the mine talk. I really do. But we've only got a few minutes before the boutique opens.
Yes, let us finish our status update. Belfry. Though your position as town secretary is nebulous, given your father's recent antics, can I count on you to take minutes?
My daddy always said, you best stay the course if you don't want to pay the horse. Of course you can.
Belfry, can we maybe have a rule about not quoting the evil mining baron Roostepher Batsinger during meetings of our top secret cabal of the real citizens of Curdle Holler?
Rawls, I do apologize. Force of habit.
Here, Belfry. I have added citizens we saw in the training video to our list of known Company Holler employees.
I was surprised to see the gargoyles on that video. You would think the guys made out of rocks wouldn't want to mine rocks.
You make an excellent point, Chipperoo. Dang, no wonder you the geological expert around here. Hang on now, it just occurred to me. Ain't none of us really got no title no more.
Sheriff, you raise an interesting point. We operate outside the law here at the real citizens of Curdle Holler headquarters, fighting for our town's frightful Halloween spirit and rightful leadership.
Well, now, does that make us good guys or bad guys? We're doing what's right, you know, but it ain't the law, per se, as such.
Sheriff, I think you just developed your own code of ethics. Belfry, are you paying attention?
Bonita, now you gotta quit acting like I'm the same long-nosed fool I used to be. Man can learn and grow, can't he?
You tell me.
All right, you two, stop bickering. As the real town's geology expert and the chosen one for today's exciting top-secret mission, I think we need to focus.
Yeah, you tell him, buddy.
Yes, thank you, Chip. Our goal for today is simple. Continue to fight against the crush of Company Holler into our town. We have already lost many businesses to their expansion. My dojo has gone from katas to nada.
Yeah, I'm really sorry about that, Fred. It's really unsettling to watch those Company Holler creeps take over the town. Which is why we've got to go out there and help people stay spooky. We can't keep losing our town's monsters to those corporate jerks.
Before we begin our day, is everyone wearing the real citizens of Curdle Holler Secret Society lapel pin?
I still can't believe you didn't let me design the lapel pins.
It's because we didn't want our Secret Society symbol to be a monster truck, Chip. Or a hot dog with googly eyes, or whatever you would have picked.
I believe we have made an excellent choice, team. The red carnation, a flower of evocation, to remind us of the town we love and have lost. The initials R and C, corresponding with real citizens. I wear mine with pride today.
Yep, same here, me too. Yeah.
You know it.
Looking good, y'all.
We've all got our assignments. Let's go.
Yep, we're next in line, Venus. And it's stacking up. Can you believe all these people are here to sign up for the mines? No, not forever. You'll just be undercover for a little while, remember? We're doing a mission. I'm gonna find Roostepher Batsinger's office and place you temporarily on a table or something so we can hear and see everything that's going on. We want to know what he's planning and what he's doing with all our fright power. Oh, don't worry about that. I have +3 charm against all admin assistants, secretaries, and office staff. You just watch.
Now point to your bottom. Pick your nose. Show me your muscle. You're hired. Through that door, grab a glow-in-the-dark rock pail and proceed warily to the mine. There you go. Slump your shoulders. Next.
Good.
Name?
Chip, clearly. On behalf of the citizens of Curdle Holler.
Point to your bottom.
Oh, no. Isadora, can I just say, that is a beautiful...
Nope.
What are you...
Don't say nothing about my name, my scarf, or my gorgeous ice dogs. I am an honor graduate of Roostepher Batsinger Secretarial School, and I am immune to all flirts, tricks, and Halloween candy, so don't even try, Buster.
Buster?
Going on break.
I don't know, Venus.
Company tour starts in 5 minutes.
Hello. Oh, come on. We have to. This is a perfect chance to get near or maybe in Roostepher Batsinger's office. It's fate, Venus. Yes, I remember. They said, Chip, do not get naked invisible and try to sneak inside the works or anything, even though you're a genius and it's a good idea and you have no other choice. Yes, it was. Okay, then. Let's join that tour. When we're close to the objective, I'll drop you off and head back to the boutique. It's a perfect plan!
Belfry, I see you ain't packed no lunch. You want some of my buy-any sausages?
No, thank you.
You want some of this here potted meat?
No, Hoss, I'm all right.
Well, now you got to eat something.
I'll have you know, Sheriff, I might be on a bit of a reducing diet. Seems all my do-gooding of late has caused a powerful increase in my appetite.
Well, now, I know you see all them fancy ladies and Batmen and them fashion magazines, and you think you gotta be just like them, you know, but I'm gonna
tell
you...
Sheriff, I don't believe I'm in need of...
Hey, Terry!
Sir?
Come over here a minute.
What you want, Yellow Hat? I'm over here bossing these litter busters!
Hey, Terry, look, I found a cigarette.
Look, Terry, I'm pretending to smoke it.
That's good, y'all, but put it in the crud bag with the other trash!
Terry... Tell Belfry what I tell you about self-esteem.
When you look in the mirror, sir, you gotta say, I like who I am.
That's right. You hear that, Belfry?
Sheriff, I've done many things in my afterlife and aim grand supreme willing to do many more. But I simply cannot conceive of babbling sweet talk to my own reflection in the mirror.
Well, now, that's why you ain't happy with yourself, Belfry. That's why you done all that evil all them times.
Sheriff, I sure would like it if we could talk about any other thing.
You know, that's why them young folk out there, you see them picking up litter? That's why they out there doing it. See, I'm a mentor and a role model, and I build them up. I build you up too, Belfry.
Well, you know, I appreciate that, Bones, but it's something called dignity, you know. Here they come. Pile in.
I'm the one who's sitting in the middle. I'm going to control the windows. I'm going to plug in my phone, and we're going to get the thing out loose, okay? Okay, we're done picking up litter around the stupid giant ice cream cone. The old Reaper man and the dog said we could be done.
Thank you, young people, for your civic-mindedness.
The old man and the dog are pretty righteous. They're both rocking the red carnation.
Marco, it sounds so cool when you say the secret society thing.
Yeah, Marco! You make these dumb old flower pins a million times cooler!
How do I join the secret society of rebels?
Casey, you done already in it? That's literally what we're doing right now. Helping the public, you know, gauging sentiment.
And working on our self-esteem. Y'all buckled in back there. Where we off to next, Sheriff?
Next up, we're gonna help Pastor Munch up at the church and maybe see if he wants to be a red carnation.
I want bubble tea.
Last call for the company tour.
Mummy Man, are you joining the mine?
I don't know, you know. It seems oppressive and evil. Plus, our town was pretty great to begin with.
But they got those critters.
Yeah, but it's your whole life, man. And Halloween's right around the corner.
One of the critters is sleeping, and his shirt comes up over his big old belly.
I didn't know that.
And the best part is, all employee housing is located adjacent to the mine, where you'll spend all day toiling in darkness for Mr. Batsinger. Sir, I've noticed you haven't signed the clipboard. Shall I put you down for a job in the mine?
No thanks. My house already has both bed and toilet.
Ooh la la! I don't know about your house, but our homes were built in the Company Holler School District, and the school is a saloon.
I play collegiate student badness named Roostepher Batsinger.
Good job, Elias. Have a drink.
Gary has a complaint. Gary needs to speak with the manager.
Come on.
What's he saying?
he said, back to the mine. Can't wait to get more of that good old fried ore for Mr. Batsinger.
And who are those scarecrows? Dragging poor Gary Gristle back to the mine.
That is a straw man. Created from pure magic by Mr. Batsinger, these creatures provide security for Company Holler. They protect our employees from workplace dangers like asking questions, taking breaks, or concerned family members. They're easily identified by their sackcloth skin, droopy caps, and silly frowns. See a straw man to ask for more work.
Venus, look!
The refinery is our home, and the furnace is the hearth. All the fright ore you'll help us collect is emptied here into this great drum, where it is then heated by ghost fire to release what? Can anyone guess?
Fright power!
Very good! The fright power is released as steam and conducted into handsome storage barrels that empty into our great Company Holler silo.
Not the ice cream cones? Isn't that against Halloween law?
Who would like to see the company store?
Venus, I think we've seen enough. Let's go find Big Daddy Batsinger. Yes, I'm gonna be careful.
Jack, and you're listening to Curdle Holler Radio, where we're playing nothing but graveyard smashes from here to Halloween. Coming up next, we've got the late, great Tommy Tomb and his number one song, Wall Me With the Cask, brought to you by Roostepher Batsinger's Company Holler. We love to mine and it shows.
Okay, team, while we're waiting on Hal and Jack, let's restate the plan and visualize it going well.
I like this idea, Bonita, even if the technique does seem a bit new age for you.
Oh, thanks. I got it from Albert. We used to do this all the time when he was caretaker.
You miss him, don't you, Mama?
Not your mother, Pumpkin. Don't know why you always call me that, but yes, I do. I hope he's enjoying his meditation retreat.
You want to leave him a message on my Ouija board?
Maybe later. Anyway, Minerva, can you hear us over there?
Yeah, kid, I'm listening. I'm just tinkering with this intercom. Whoa, too much torque.
Ooh, let me talk on it, Granny. Breaker, 10-4, this is Pumpkin.
Pumpkin, I know it's been tough for you ever since you had to shut down your candy factory.
So that mean old Batman don't take it over.
Correct, Pumpkin. It was a difficult but wise choice. The less of our town that can be absorbed into Batsinger's Company Holler, the better.
Yes, and we all hate his guts and his stupid fake town, and I welcome your company here, but I'm still going to ask you to focus.
I'm focused. I can say the plan.
Go ahead, Pumpkin.
We're going to go ask Howlin' Jack, the radio man, if he wants to fight the bad guy.
Right, but we're going to be cool about it, right?
We're gonna go ask Howlin' Jack, the radio man, to help us fight the bad guy, and we're gonna be cool and wearing sunglasses.
Close enough.
Knock, knock, preacher.
Yes, my brothers. Come on into my office, Sheriff and Mr. Batsinger.
Well, me and the Litter Busters just wanted to give you a little update on this list of things that needed done around the church.
I appreciate y'all so much. We've had a hard time keeping our sacred and special church building up to code here lately. And I have to pay my weekly tithe to them old Company Holler strawmen. Seems like my collection plate's got a hole in it.
Nope, nope, not no more, Preacher. We done patched that hole.
Well, thank y'all. I'm such a blessed man, aren't I, Peaches? Peaches gets a little wild in here sometimes as well. He's the one that went ping-ponging into my stained glass window.
Well, of course he did. But you can't put a price on the love of a loyal pet. Isn't that right, Peaches?
Well, you know, or maybe you can. That window took about 150 zap to repair. Come right out of our real citizens of Curdle Holler petty cash.
Sheriff, perhaps we do not outright mention the source of our generous donations to the church.
Oh, right. You know, we just had some old stained glass in the glove compartment of the police cruiser. That's how we fixed your window.
Well, y'all have been so generous to our church that I almost feel bad for asking. But have y'all taped up all my torn hymnals? We had a werewolf in here on Sunday.
Yes, sir.
We also had a leak in the baptismal pool.
Corked it.
And all my flannel board store characters were stuck together.
Unstuck them.
Bats in the belfry?
Belfry got them.
And then I hate to bother you, but we've also run out of saltines and apple juice for the church nursery.
Oh, yeah, we sent the youngins up to Price Slashers. Gonna go pick that up for you, Preacher. At Marco Drive, pretty reckless. They gonna be back in a flash.
Wonderful. I can't thank y'all enough. Your help is gonna be enough to help our struggling little church stay afloat a bit longer.
Love to hear that, Pastor Munch. It's been real nice to see you.
It's nice to see you too, Belfry. Being so kind and helpful and wearing that real nice lapel pin.
Oh, I'm so glad you noticed my dapper little accessory. See here now, Preacher. This red carnation.
Oh, doodlebugs. I almost forgot.
What'd you forget, Preacher? But let's not forget we talking about Belfry's handsome lapel pin. I got one too, see? I wear it on my hat brim.
Collection plate, Patrol.
Again? Already?
Yeah.
Oh, dear. Let me see what I can wrestle up. Well, I just remembered one more little chore if y'all got a minute. It would help our struggling church and keep it from closing its creaky wooden doors.
Well, all right, Hoss. What is it?
I need y'all to help me make a few phone calls.
He's almost done. Hello.
Give it 1 minute.
Mr. Hockey Mask, do you work on this building?
Outhouse?
No, the other building. The Gothic Revival Mansion with imposing walls, turrets, and a roving bale of straw men?
Me have to go. Straw men say 5 minute and go.
Okay, just real quick. I'm supposed to give this charming gift to Mr. Batsinger. You know if he's home?
He ain't, Doctor. He got everything to get out bad humors. Uh-oh, Percy up early today.
Yikes. Thanks, buddy. That's all we need. Hey, you should leave this place. Go to the boutique. You know where that is? We'll take care of you.
We have an organization.
Okay, first need all country rock critters.
Hear that, Venus? Nobody's home. Yeah, let's do it. But first, the invisible man needs to go clear and stash these clothes.
Well, hello there, sir. This is a member survey being conducted on behalf of the First Expired Church of Curdle Holler. Is now a good time to ask you your household income? Well, suit yourself. The chain man done hung up on me. The gall of that metal man.
Okay, next question. On a scale from 1 to 5, 1 being not, and 5 being very, would you describe yourself as a person who loves sunsets?
Very. 5.
Okay, next question. Do you have a good sense of humor?
Hey,
Can we be done? Terry and Marco got bored doing chores, so they're just like racing around the sanctuary.
Should I say your name or should I say my name?
Hey, Marco! I got all these old pews out of the way. Now we can really go.
Time to blow the horn on this chapel.
Well, Miss Casey, the preacher has asked us to telephone the number of his parishioners and ask them a series of questions. I thought he was wanting us to rattle their pockets for donations, but that don't seem to be today's chapter and verse.
Mr. Goliath? Charlie Ratbone? Gary Gristle? These are like a bunch of weird old dudes.
Yes, and I just have a few more calls to place to these senior scamps. Would you like to help?
Whatever. Hey, the preacher wants to know if you're a good listener.
I can always repeat back exactly what you say.
Okay, now final question. On a scale of 1 to 5, 1 being not, and 5 being very, how ready are you to get married to a mature woman of means?
1? You look good.
Something stinks in here. It's not just the preacher's pet octajaw. I ain't telling you nothing you don't already know, Peaches.
Knock, knock, phone friends. How's it going in here?
I just figured since I done said all that stuff...
Well, we almost through with your list of calls, Preacher. But I can't help but notice that these survey questions are like spots on a measles monster. They're all over the place.
Well, I'm always trying new ways to reach out to my members.
And I know that's subjective now.
And Mr. High Five, would you describe yourself as good at fixing things around the house?
Yeah, I'm a real handyman.
All right.
You know, Pastor, some might say that these questions are more befitting of romantic courtship than of church matters.
I ain't everybody's cup of tea, you know.
Well, I always think that going to church is like courting. You put on a nice shirt and you slick back your hair.
Okay, that was the last old man call. Can we be done now?
I'm done too, and I only got one complete survey. I just added up them numbers like you said, Preacher, and we got a score of 7 out of 32 for old Copycat. That ain't good, huh?
Oh, dear. What about Mr. Goliath?
Hung up.
And Ronnie Roach?
Left a message, but his answering machine said he does not take unsolicited calls.
Well, Brody Gooseberries, this is harder than I thought it would be. Half of my list was gone to Company Holler working in the mines. And I could have swore we would have had a match from the others.
A match for what now?
Well...
Now we're coming to you dead with another uninterrupted block of monster mashes and Halloween party jams. Right after this word from our sponsor. Are you tired of being broke? Don't want to wait till trick-or-treat to recharge your fright-powered stores? Well, you've been personally invited by caretaker Roostepher Batsinger to join him at Company Holler and work in the fright mines. Company Holler, where you can't swing the pickaxe without hitting a friend. And Hal and Jack is out, folks. Stay spooky out there.
All right, all done.
I thought you was gonna let me read the school closings.
Pumpkin, it's not snowing. There are no school closures.
Curdle Holler School of Beauty is closed. Curdle Holler Technical Center is 1 hour delay.
Ignore him, Hal and Jack. He's being weird.
Excuse you.
Anyway, thank you so much for letting us schedule some time with you here at the radio station.
Yes, Hal and Jack. We consider you a trusted friend and ally.
Right on. I'm always happy to talk to my good friend Count Fangula and his coterie of cool cats. It's a groovy distraction from the way things are going around here.
What, you mean, the constant heavy-handed ad reads for Company Holler?
Yes, we could not help but notice that all your sponsors have scuttled away. What happened?
I don't know, man. Our advertisers seem to disappear overnight, like cattle near the vampire pen. All that's keeping the station afloat is the ads from Company Holler, and they're turning our listeners into pod people. Hello, you've reached Hal and Jack.
Hey, I'm calling in to win one of them country rock critters.
Slow that Mustang down, Sally. We're not running a contest right now. I'm not even on the air.
Well, can you just go get me one?
Fred, this is grim.
Agree, Bonita. Surely, Howlin' Jack will prove sympathetic to our cause.
You're welcome, ma'am. Thanks for being a loyal listener. In all my years on the air, I've never seen anything like this. And I've DJed through the phone booth stuffing craze, hula hoop madness, Freddy Sweater Mania, and meanie babies.
Yes, it almost seems like this Company Holler thing is really costing our town its very soul, is something someone might say. I wonder if you would agree with someone who said that.
I couldn't agree more, Miss Von Wangencamp. You should have heard me howl when I had to close down Curdle Cadaver's Pizzeria. Company Holler opened up their own robot pizza joint, and I just couldn't compete.
They had to close down pizza? That's the saddest thing I ever heard.
Me too, bud.
Howling Jack, I have in my hand a small lapel pin in the shape of a red carnation. You might notice that many like-minded real citizens of Curdle Holler are wearing the same accessory and fighting for our frightful town. May I give this to you?
Right on. I'm tired of these Company Holler goons, and I'm all about sticking it to the man. What do you need from me?
We'd like to use your transmitter.
That was close, Venus. But we're here. Roostepher Batsinger's weird old man office.
Finally.
I know. It smells like cigars and butterscotch. We've got to spin the globe, Venus. All this stuff is horrible, but fascinating. Like if a wizard was the principal of a hunting lodge. Oh yeah, the desk! Perfect. Let me fix your note so it's legit. Yeah, he'll think you're one of these other gifts. And I know ours is fake, because you're really a spy recording his every move, but these other gifts are terrible. I mean, canned fish. It's okay. Okay, I'm leaving. You're gonna do great. Remember, call us if he says anything about his plans or starts doing anything funny, like burps or Crap! Don't worry. I'll slip out when he's not looking.
Boy, well, I never. Phlegmatic. Phlegmatic my foot. I have half a mind to banish that fool doctor to the land of... my globe. Siam should always face the window. Come on out. I know you are there. I see you in your birthday suit. Yes, I see you behind the curtain. Well, not see, but us bats have the gift of sonar location. No, don't try to escape. You are no match for the straw man.
You are not the caretaker. You can't do this.
Are you certain? I have done so much already.
The fright power belongs to Curdle Holler. This is a Halloween town, not some dumb dirt-time dig town.
Are you the gentleman who saved me and Percy from the mine? Yes, you are, Chip Clearly. How did you make it all the way to my office?
It's a pretty good company tour.
Why not reclaim your dignity and pull on one of my great coats? Shall I play the orchestrion?
I have no idea.
Sir, I wager you are here to steal my personal documents or observe me in secret.
Well, it's a secret, so...
Chip, you must be very loyal to your friends to risk yourself this way. Are you always the first to volunteer no matter the danger? And what did your friends say to this reckless notion? Were they not concerned for your well-being? Well, this is your own doing. They would not have allowed it.
They're good friends.
They worry about me. Well, maybe they don't give you the rope to do everything you can do.
Well, you can't always do whatever you want, Mr. Batsinger.
And yet you did just that, Chip Clearly, because I believe you understand the power of one person to do big things.
You don't sound like Secretary Batsinger.
Secretary?
Can I go?
What to do with Chip Clearly? Pastor Munch, do you really mean to tell us that we've been making phone calls intended to match some wealthy old church lady with the man of her dreams? I'm feeling some kind of indignation.
Well, please don't be upset. Y'all remember Maud Lynn? She's lonesome.
Well, Preacher, that's real sweet of you, but I just gotta tell you what, I don't know how fixing up some old gal's supposed to help you flounder in church.
Well, she said if I could help her find a husband, she would give a big donation to the church. But I've been through all the bachelors in town, and it doesn't seem like anybody wants to marry her. Unless one of y'all does.
Preacher, what you talking about? You know I'm dating my ex-wife.
Well, how about you, Belfry?
How about me Jackstraws? How about you, Pastor?
I don't think she wants to date me. She's allergic to afterjaws.
That was one of the questions in that there phone survey now.
Are y'all sure you can't think of anybody else?
Sheriff, what about Apple Bob?
I think he's dating Ring Toss.
Confound it! Why am I even trying to help you think of some other old men? It's serious now, Pastor Munch. That Company Holler is causing all manner of ruination in this town. Your church not least of all.
Alone, you may be right, Belfry. But how am I supposed to stop him?
Collection plate, Patrol.
But I ain't got nothing else to give, Brother Strawman. I can offer you a prayer, though. Let's all bow our heads, and I'm gonna say it.
You all might want to unbow your heads and look over there.
So crises, take the wheel! We out of control!
Bail out of the cab, Terry. This holy hacienda is about to glow.
Yeah, the police cruiser just fell through the church floor.
Oh, dang, nabbit. Terry, now you know better than to joyride inside the house of the Grand Supreme.
I'm real sorry, sir. I'll fix it.
Oh, man.
Well, Pastor Munch, I'm sorry we couldn't secure Maud Lynn's donation for you. And also that members of our party seem to have drove a car through your floor. But we did help to the best of our admittedly pitiful abilities.
That's okay, Brother Batsinger. I think this is the sign I've been looking for. It's time for a change.
Well, surely you ain't looking to change careers, Pastor. I can't imagine you doing anything else.
No, they got a spot for me to preach up at Company Holler. New church building, a rec center with ping pong table, and they'll let me work in the mines when I'm not preaching.
Now, Pastor, that don't sound like a very square deal. Let me take a look at that there paperwork.
It's too late. I've already signed the contract.
You come with me.
Look, you come with the free country rock critter. It's the one with the beach towel and sunglasses. He's darling. I just know I'm gonna love working in the mines.
Yeah, already started. Feel like a water bug on a sewing needle. From this height, we can reach every radio in town.
Sweet. We'll only get one shot at that, so we'll make it count.
Have you heard from Chip?
No. I will assume he did not follow directions.
Probably. He'll be okay. Hey, gotta go. See you at the boutique when I'm done here.
Hey, what are you doing?
TV repair.
You need to fix it so I can watch Little Ratskulls.
Well, this is the Little Ratskulls wire, but my hands are too big, so you'll have to help.
Give me that. I gotta do everything in this stupid town.
All right, take the black wire and connect it to the red wire.
Ow!
Try the green one.
Hey!
Oh, okay, I see. It's the yellow wire.
One time, little rat school's got a firecracker and they blowed up a whole mailbox.
There you go. Now here's the next step. Okay, honey, you're all set up with the voice changer and enough juice to reach the whole town. Ready?
Here we go.
Attention, ghosts and goblins!
I bring you a spooky cool message from the real citizens of Curdle Holler.
Those who still live the Halloween mission.
Turn it up!
Halloween lives and will thrive again.
Despite the actions of one Roostepher Batsinger, we resist.
With tooth and claw and hockey mask.
The oppressor will tempt you with trinkets and false promises, but we urge you to remember what's important.
The thrill of night. The crinkle of candy. The pride of a well-made costume. The raw fear of humans on Halloween.
The company says you're just a worker, asks you to ignore your spooky nature, but you are a Halloween creature.
We call upon you now, mummies and minotaurs, imps and jack-o'-lanterns, slugs, skeletons and slime, goblins, headless horsemen,
mermaids, fiends and friends.
Join our rebellion. Look for those who wear the red carnation. Only 2 weeks remain until Halloween. We must be ready.
I am the voice.
And you totally don't know who I am, so don't try to figure it out. When I speak to you again, I will have instructions.
Nice job, kid.
Now we're doing it. Caretaker style.
I see monsters on the road.
And our rebel recruiters with red carnations.
Nice work, everybody.
Chip, I'm still confused. Roostepher just let you go?
He seen you? The invisible man?
Yeah, sonar. Which is cheating, by the way.
Chip, that was so dangerous what you did.
But it worked, didn't it? Venus is there right now, set to tattletale mode. You need to stop worrying about me so much and let me do stuff.
Okay, we're just glad you're back.
Thanks. We did good today. Oh, he gave me this for Batsinger Jr.
Belfry, I heard rumors of your recent ambition, but they must be tall tales, for I learned that my son is a secretary.
He'd be a chauvinist?
He's so.
All right.
Hey, you're doing fine, Belfry. Right on track.
You made an important step today, but Roostepher will respond. My eyes and ears report strawmen in the streets, seeking to reclaim some lost souls, but also hunting rebels.
We had to expect that, but we're ready now. I've been thinking about a big move, and I want to do it soon.
Now you're talking. What's the plan?
Ding dong, alert babies. Is message from Venus the Tattletale.
Venus? What's she saying?
Looks like she knows what Roostepher's doing with the fright power. She knows where it's going.
Where?
Earth.